Welcome back.
Hey, it's good to be back, buddy. It is good to be back.
I know. Tell me about it. What'd you do in the off season, man?
Now you have to be so precise on this jump. You're landing on a 2-inch ledge. Oh!
Just focused, man. You know, stayed on the grind, in the gym, eating right, doing the right things, getting ready for a productive 2016.
As a good pro would.
Absolutely. Man. What about you, man? What have you been up to?
Daddy! Oh, you know me, man, the wild man. I'm just a little bit of this.
Pew, 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 pew.
You know, it's all good.
I wouldn't expect anything less. Mikey, McGee. Welcome back to LA here.
I heard you were coming back.
Good to see ya.
Love to see you, bro.
Thanks, man.
What'd you get into this offseason, man?
Glad to be back in LA, guys.
That's the truth.
Glad to have you, bud. man. Welcome back.
Hey, it's good to be back, buddy. It is good to be back.
I know. Tell me about it. What'd you do in the offseason, man?
Now you have to be so precise on this jump. You're landing on a 2-inch ledge.
Just focused, man. You know, stayed on the grind, in the gym, eating right, doing the right things, getting ready for a productive 2016.
As a good pro would.
Absolutely. Man. What about you, man? What have you been up to?
Oh, you know me, man, the wild man. I'm just a little bit of this.
Pew, 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 pew.
You know, it's all good.
I wouldn't expect anything less. Mikey, McGee. Well, welcome back to LA here.
I heard you were coming back.
Good to see ya.
Love to see you, bro.
Thanks, man.
What'd you get into this offseason, man?
Glad to be back in LA, guys.
That's the truth.
Glad to have you, bud.
from StubHub Center in Carson, California. Welcome to LA Galaxy preseason action. Tonight, the Galaxy open the exhibition campaign when they host Armenian side FC Shirak. Hello again and welcome, Joe Tutino, alongside Hall of Famer Kobe Jones. Thank you for joining us tonight as we get reintroduced to a reshaped Galaxy roster. We expected changes, Kobe, but this many changes?
I don't think anybody expected this many changes this early on before the season starts. But you know what? This is a Galaxy side that wanted to make some changes and want to get ready not only for MLS but also for CONCACAF Champions League.
I think Bruce Arena concentrated extensively in the back of the Galaxy in goal and along that defensive line. But the back four, we still don't know what it's going to look like.
And I think this is what it's all about this preseason. This is what it's for. It's for testing things out, and that's exactly what they're going to do. Quite a few names have been bantered about as far as still coming to the Galaxy in that back line. So tonight is going to be an example to see who can step up and who can play well and who's going to be fighting for a spot. There's only four positions there, but I mean, we're talking about like six or seven players fighting for those positions.
Thank you to Donovan Ricketts. Of course, thank you to Omar Gonzalez and Juninho. Both players are now in Mexico. Both players are playing well, and they certainly gave the Galaxy some great service.
And they gave great service over the years. Let's not forget as well, you know, Todd Donovan with his retirement. You know, this is an important time for the Galaxy because not only a lot of changes coming about, but as you mentioned, in the back line, but also the spine of the team. When you talk about Juninho being gone, you talk about Omar Gonzalez being gone, and every coach will tell you, they always mention that spine is where you have to have stability. Well, the Galaxy, they've made quite a few changes there, so we'll see what happens for them this season.
New names we're going to be calling, and some are familiar names. Ashley Cole is a member of the Galaxy. He's not here yet, although we're going to see Emmanuel Boateng tonight. We'll see Jeff Laurentiewicz. You know that name in Major League Soccer with New England and with Chicago. Hey, welcome back to Mike McGee. Did he bring back his goalkeeper's gloves? We'll find out. And Gilles Van Dam is one of those defenders you were alluding to. He's not here yet, but on his way.
Yeah, I mean, it's incredible when you think about it. If you think about this Galaxy squad from last year, but also let's think about 2 years ago, all the changes that have occurred, it's very different. It's a revamping of the LA Galaxy.
Second year, full year, though, for Giovanni Dos Santos and Steven Gerrard, this should be a big boost for them.
Yeah, to be here from the beginning, to have that preseason under your belt and have a knowledge of your teammates from the start, from preseason on, so important. And I think you'll see a big difference in their play.
We told you Donovan Ricketts is gone. Dan Kennedy back in Los Angeles, and this time in a Galaxy net. And I think there's improvement in goal.
Yeah, I think I think a lot of people from LA Galaxy and MLS know Dan Kennedy from his Chivas days.
Yes.
But now LA Galaxy through and through.
Our contest is underway. We'll get you the lineups as we continue here. This is an exhibition game, of course. There'll be a lot of substitutions throughout the night. In fact, I believe Bruce Arena is going to go with one starting 11 now and a second starting 11 in the second half. Here comes FC Shirak up the near side here with a long cross to the back post. It'll be out of play. Goal kick, Galaxy. Let's get you the Galaxy lineup. Dan Kennedy in goal. Dave Romney, Leonardo, AJ De La Garza, and Robbie Rogers are the back four. Giovanni Dos Santos, Bajo Husidic, Steven Gerrard, and Emmanuel Boateng in the middle of the park. And then it's the captain, Robbie Keane, and Alan Gordon as the target forward here tonight for the Galaxy. Kennedy. Leonardo, who was the Galaxy's Defender of the Year in 2015, made some pretty good strides, became a consistent player, right, throughout the last season, I think?
Yeah, and I think that was the most important thing for Leonardo because there's a lot of talk, and he had quite a few struggles over his first few years here with the Galaxy, but getting that consistency down and just being a solid all-around defender, not making any mental mistakes, was the important part for him, and I think he did a good job of that.
Here's Kennedy. Trying to find Robbie Keane here. He'll come back for Steven Gerrard, his first touch. On to the right side, Dos Santos now. He's got some help wide if he wants it. Goes in towards center for Robbie Keane, and out comes the keeper, and he'll collect it. Abrahamian in goal for FC Shirak.
Well, that little run from Dos Santos is exactly what the Galaxy want. They've brought in, you know, Emmanuel Boateng on that left side to give some speed. And they have, we know what Dos Santos can do on that right side, but they want to have those wingers running at players, drawing defenders, which will open up more space for Robbie Keane up top.
Here's Keane now for the Galaxy. Tried to find Dos Santos. One of the things we talked about last year was the fact that the Galaxy did not have that speed on the wide positions.
Yeah, that was a bit of a struggle for the Galaxy, but I think this year with the addition of Boateng, that's going to help out. Yep.
There's a good chance top of the area here. Nice job by Romney getting in front. Boateng will come out with possession. Alan Gordon will get the foul and a free kick.
FC Shirak with Hakubayan on that left side, picking up the ball and just running across the face of the Galaxy defense. That's something where the Galaxy struggled a little bit last year, letting players go across the top of the defense. That's something where they're going to need to have players have that communication and step out and press the ball this year. I think that's one of the big issues for them.
Galaxy big call for a foul here as Dos Santos was dispossessed of the ball. It's going to be a free kick for FC Shirak. Across the defense, the Mankovic, Hovhannisyan, Darbinian, Davoyan for FC Shirak. Malakian, Dirasuba are the midfielders. Kaba and Kouakou are the forwards. Excuse me, five in the midfield. Kaba's another midfielder. Kouakou is the forward, the lone forward here. Here's the ball into the area, cleared away by Gerard. Numbers forward for FC Shirak. Another clearance, this time by Romney into midfield. And the visitors coming out in the attack in the first 4 minutes of this contest. De La Garza in trouble, deep in his own defense. He's able to clear it out. Good job that time. Now Dos Santos back into midfield. He'll switch it across. Boateng. It's away from one defender. Nice run here by Gerard down the middle of the park. He'll find Alan Gordon back across the top of the box and clear it away. Throw in. Bruce Arena showing a lot of confidence in Dave Romney. Brought him up in that Houston game, remember last year, and all of a sudden began getting more and more minutes. And has put himself as a potential starter here now.
Well, that's the thing. Once you start playing consistently, all of a sudden, you know, you're going to find yourself on the pitch a lot more.
Here comes Dos Santos. Robbie Rogers on his left foot. Whips it into the area almost. Found Robbie Keane. This will be cleared away. Malakian able to get it top of the box. Nice job by Alan Gordon to get it back. Now in the midfield. Kouakou, slowed a bit by Rogers. Galaxy do well to get numbers behind the ball here. Here's Malakian, again on the left side. You'll be hearing Malakian a lot because there are two on the field, both brothers. Here's a good chance at the top of the box. It's blocked. Galaxy want an offside. They'll get it. Kouakou, I should say, in an offside position who played the ball. So possession here to the Galaxy.
Well, we're seeing for FC Shirak just a consistent attack down their left-hand side where you see Malakian, you know, making sure that he picks up the ball. He feels comfortable on the ball, and he's trying to look every time for Hakubayan in the middle where he's drifting inside and picking up that ball right outside the 18 of the Galaxy.
Here's Leonardo under some pressure. Romney, again, pressure on the ball. Good work here by FC Shirak. Romney will get it back, though, on the throw. Gordon taking off the ball there. Hakubayan taken off by Romney.
Good job by Romney in that tight space, able to, you know, relieve the pressure with three defenders on him.
Dos Santos wants the foul. He's not going to get it. Here's Kouakou, and his shot on goal is saved by Dan Kennedy. Dos Santos. He'll find back Gerard. Romney. Again, Girard one more time here as the Galaxy will whip it around midfield. Bajo Husidic, that's the question mark, that position, not necessarily Bajo. But who is that player that's going to play alongside Steven Girard? I mean, the loss of Juninho there, that's a big one.
Well, there's been a huge loss for the Galaxy over the past couple of years in that central midfield position. You know, when you think about the energy, you know, and pretty much the engine of the LA Galaxy over the past 2 years, where Marcelo Sarvas 2 years ago, Juninho this year. So it'll be interesting to see how they adjust and who's going to play alongside Girard. That's going to do, to be honest, a lot of the dirty work, a lot of that grunt running.
It's a different position now because you have a player that's much older in Steven Girard, and you can't expect him to go 90 minutes all the way up and down, up and down. So you're going to have that help almost to the latter part of Cienfuegos' career. Is that fair or no?
Different type of players, but I guess the philosophy is the same. You can't think that if you have a Sarvas and a Juninho, it's going to be the same as a Girard and someone else there.
Right. Dirasuva playing it through, offside. Akobian was in an offside position there. Dan Kennedy will restart it. 9 minutes into this one. Thank you for joining us here at LAGalaxy.com. The season coming in a hurry. Next week, the Galaxy take on, or February 9th, I should say, the Galaxy take on Club Tijuana in another friendly. They have Seattle on the schedule as well. Then the Champions League match. And March 6th, it opens for real against DC United. Right here at StubHub Center. Leonardo. Nice movement here by the Galaxy. Husidic. Dos Santos able to find Robbie Rogers. He'll take it into the corner. His cross. Trying to find Gordon. He can't get on the end of it. Husidic to keep it alive. Back out it goes. Keane lets it go for Girard. His shot is blocked. Boateng to keep it alive. He'll get the throw in out of this. Good work here by the Galaxy.
Yeah, the Galaxy are just shifting the ball around. A lot of quick touches, quick passes, just moving this FC Shirak defense around and not able to get close to the ball. But most of the attack has really come down the right side for the Galaxy, going through Dos Santos.
And the runs by Robbie Rogers, right? Stretching that out, giving him the outlet, right?
Yeah, Robbie Rogers, yes, getting forward is important, but the player that's been on the ball that's been the most dangerous so far in these first, you know, 10 minutes of the match has been Dos Santos. And that is important for the Galaxy to have their DP player step up and be involved in every single match this year.
Here's Leonardo. Rogers will call him off. Back to Dan Kennedy. Hey, the two most storied clubs in MLS history, your five-time MLS Cup champion LA Galaxy, open the season against DC United Sunday, March 6th. The match presented by StubHub. Tickets start as low as $20 at LAGalaxy.com. We hope to see you here. Now, DC United's been rumored to be going after Marcelo Sarvas from Colorado. So he could be here on December the 6th, depending on what happens. Here's FC Shirak on the attack, and they'll get the first corner of the evening.
You look at FC Shirak and how they're playing this match so far. You can see where their strengths are. It's down the wings, you know, on both sides, both flanks. Akobian on that right-hand side and Malakian on the left. They've been pretty successful at getting behind the Galaxy defense, and at the very least, threatening the back line of the LA Galaxy.
Now, FC Shirak, of course, is in mid-season at this point. It's an opportunity at the near side, and still in play. The Galaxy thought it was out of play, but no, we're continuing here. Another cross into the box, knocked away by Alan Gordon. Now, Bruce Arena wants to see 45 minutes out of this group tonight. He felt in training this week that he felt that his starters were about 35 minutes fit. You know, it's a work in progress to get ready.
It's preseason.
Yeah.
They should be 35 minutes fit at this point.
So he's hoping to get 45 from these guys, and he'll get another 11 out there. We will see Mike McGee making his return to a Galaxy pitch here at StubHub Center in a Galaxy uniform. So that'll be good for the fans, I imagine. Lucidic. Back to AJ De La Garza. I know he's very happy to be back in Los Angeles.
Well, I think Mike McGee's probably thinking, you know, I'm back in L.A.
Yeah.
Great weather. But let's also remember probably one of his most successful seasons was here in Los Angeles. I'm sure he's trying to, thinking that he can replicate that.
I hope so. And they had a very good connection with Robbie Keane previously. And hopefully they can replicate that. He is coming back from some serious injuries, though. So hopefully he can return to being that same player. Here's Boateng. Turning the corner on his defender. Good move there. He'll get the corner kick out of it. Nice speed.
Well, showing the burst of speed is Boateng on that left-hand side. And that's something different for the Galaxy.
Quick corner taken, and the opportunity towards goal is knocked away. We'll come out to Girard. Lucidic. Tried to find, I believe, Boateng. It's been cleared out. Here comes the counterattack as the Galaxy looks to get some numbers back. Nice job there by Baggio. Staying with the play, and the Galaxy do get possession. Girard. Alan Gordon. He was re-signed. He was out of contract in the offseason. Bruce Arena said, no, we're going to keep him. Boateng. Here's Keane. Can't get the shot away. Sidic. Bad collision right there. Both players seem to be okay. Fortunate that time. It'll be cleared out.
Well, for a preseason match, both sides, you know, the players are going into it's the tackles. Sure. A little bit of a memory there for the FC Shirak players about coming here a couple of years back and going away with a loss.
Yeah. And they have pretty good support here in Southern California, if you remember back a couple of years ago. And so they want to put on a good show.
Yeah,
not just being in L.A. They want they have fans here as well. Malakian. Kouakou. Kouakou once again able to play it back. There's a lot of room in the middle of the park right now. AJ able to clear that ball away. Girard. Sprays it to the left side for Robbie Keane, and he's able to keep it in play. Robbie, left corner of the area, watched by one defender, tried to pull it back, played well that time by Malakian, Edgar Malakian, and cleared out.
Well, you can see that's a little bit of that preseason for Robbie Keane right now. Not quite as sharp as we expect him to. Expect him to be, you know, during season where he pulls that back and gets it across the face, and regardless of what people might have thought, he's going to shoot from there.
Oh, yeah. And he should, right?
Well, yes. The way his season was last year or the last few years and since he's been with the Galaxy, it's been a goal-scoring machine.
Yep. Robbie Rogers. 16 minutes into this one, 0-0. It has been wide open for the most part. Rogers looking to find the lane. He'll find Girard here. By the way, this pitch laid down this week. Looks great. Hopefully it holds up. Boateng. He's got Romney pushing forward. Romney cut off. You'll have to play it back. Lucidic. Back out to midfield. Leonardo. De La Garza waits on this one. Finds Rogers. Now Now into the left side. Sidic under some pressure here.
Now this is pretty decent by the LA Galaxy, showing a bit of patience. They push the ball up, they're not finding the right lane to get through, and they're just holding on to the ball, not giving it up too easily.
Here's Romney this time. He'll put it on his right foot. Back out it goes. Husidic. Gerard. This time finding Dos Santos. Into Robbie Keane. And it pinballs around and out of play. And the Galaxy will get a corner kick out of it. Robbie almost found that lane to turn it towards goal.
Well, that's exactly what Robbie Keane was looking to do. And like we mentioned, and we'll continue to mention, it's not quite the sharpness. He right there, he's trying to pull it back to that left foot. But what a great combination play from Gerard to Dos Santos and then to Robbie Keane. Just the FC Shirak defender gets in just in time.
Corner by Dos Santos finds Leonardo and out. He was talking to Romney a bit on the backside of that play. Was he hoping to have him on his wide side?
No, I think Robbie Keane was complaining about a play a little while ago when the ball was at Romney's feet, that he wanted it to his right foot, that he was telling him, play it into this foot so I can go in.
So always look for me.
Do you expect anything different from Robbie Keane? Come on.
Any forward, right?
Any forward, exactly. It's one thing I found. Every great forward thinks that they should always have the ball.
Ball will come near side here. And the touch line and out of play. Dirasuba. Delagar's under some pressure. By Kouakou. Back to Kennedy and out. In possession here to FC Shirak. 19 minutes in, 0-0.
Those are the plays that frustrate a coach. And people say, why is that so bad? Is you have possession of the ball, it's your throw-in, and you end up putting your goalkeeper under pressure and kicking the ball out of bounds and giving the ball to the other team. It's those little things that are the mental backbreakers in a match.
Hovarisian. Able to get it into midfield here. Hakobian. Good pressure by Dos Santos. However, FC Shirak still on the ball. Kouakou. Watch there by De La Garza and fouled, I believe. No, handball is going to be called against Kouakou, falling on the ball and grabbing it.
Well, you got to find for Kouakou's got to understand the referee hasn't been calling a whole lot in this match so far. He's been letting things play, letting things go. So to fall and just reach out for the ball, yeah, the referee's going to make that call against you every time.
Here's Keane. Finds Gordon back out to Keane. Now Dos Santos, wide it'll go. Robbie Rogers, he had to wait on it. Husidic, Gerard into the corner. Rogers again, on his right foot this time. He'll get the cross away, knocked out.
Now for everybody watching, that's the look that you're gonna see a lot this year from the LA Galaxy, where you see Dos Santos coming in tight.
This is dangerous though. Leonardo trying to hold off Kouakou, and Dan Kennedy picks up, and Dan Kennedy, little communication problem there, or just the ball didn't get into the penalty area?
Well, when it comes down to it, A.J. De La Garza's got to do a much better job of getting that ball back to Dan Kennedy. Instead of doing it with a header, a soft header back, putting that pressure on Kennedy, he's got to make sure, let that ball drop to his feet and pass it back.
Fans, the best seats in the house, the best price, 2016 season tickets on sale right now for as low as $19.50 per game. Become a part of the family today at LAGalaxy.com. Alongside Kobe Jones, Joe Tutino, coming to you from StubHub Center tonight. The first exhibition match of the Galaxy for the upcoming season, taking on FC Shirak, 0-0, this one in the 22nd minute. Husidic lifts it long, a bit too long this time, and out of play. Many changes for this Galaxy team, maybe a couple of more names on the way. Take a look at LAGalaxy.com or social media, because it probably will come out there first. Somebody will break the news. do like the way this FC Shirak team plays. Move the ball touchline to touchline. They find the lanes between the center backs and the wide defenders.
Yeah, FC Shirak's doing a very good job. I think they're organized very well. I like how their midfield line drops right above their defensive line. You see the two lines of four, and they close down the spaces pretty quickly.
It's going to be a throw-in for the Galaxy. Yeah, good energy from them. Here's Keane. Gordon back out. Gerrard plays it back. Throw for Keane. Cleared away. Here's Dos Santos now on his left foot. Doesn't take the shot. It's cleared out. Lucidic. No foul there. We continue. And FC Shirak able to break out. Dos Santos is down and slow to get up. Looks like he's going to be all right, though. Ball through the middle of the park. Gets through everyone and runs to the goalkeeper, trying to find Edgar Malakian. Kennedy out to De La Garza. Gerrard will check back. Here's Boateng. Trying to weave his way up the field. Find Gordon. Ball goes out of play.
Talking about this FC Shirak side, I look at number 28, Cabo, and everything that he's doing in that defensive midfield role. He's been pretty solid back there. I like the way he plays. Not only on the defensive side, he's been getting stuck in as far as tackles are concerned, but also comfortable on the ball. Able to get the ball, dribble out of tight spaces, but also changes the point of attack with a vision that you usually don't see too much from defensive midfielders.
Here's Robbie Keane, watched there by Caba. Keane once again. Come back out to Gerrard, and play will continue. Shirak comes out with possession. Dirasuba. Back out to Caba. Wheel it around to the near side this time. Trying to find the corner. Robbie Rogers is there. Nice job, but it'll be a corner kick, though. Good pressure there by Hakobian. Getting that corner kick for FC Shirak. Yeah, here in the 25th.
A little bit casual in the back for Robbie Rogers there. He's, at the very least, that's got to go out for a throw-in. And at the best, it goes up the field, but you cannot... cannot give away a corner kick on that situation because the ball bounces. He has time to do what he wants with it, right. And he lets it go out for a corner.
Good battle here. Romney in the middle of the penalty area. Out of play. Goal kick. Romney and Stamenkovic. Nice little battle there before the corner. Leonardo, it's the Galaxy want to work it out of the back here. Romney able to get it towards midfield. Boateng wants to throw. It's going to be a throw in Galaxy here.
Now, one of the things that, as a coach, you're looking at right now, you're not too concerned about the physical aspect. Yes, you'd like to see them push for the 45 minutes, but you understand the legs will come, the physical nature of it. What you're looking at now, as far as the players are concerned, when you're considering starting positions, is who is ready mentally. Who can mentally, when they're tired, still keep their head and understand the match and control their game within the game. That's so important right now for every player to understand. Not making silly mistakes, making mental mistakes at this point in time.
Here's Husidic now for the Galaxy as we enter the 27th minute. Legs a little heavy at this moment. Remember, they've only been training for about a week. Gerrard.
And within that week, they've been doing a little bit of fitness.
Yes, just a bit. Boateng. Good job by the defender that time. Darbignan. The Galaxy will get it back. Boateng again. Plays it back out. You'll find Husicic. Gerard. Dos Santos trying to turn towards goal. He's taken off the ball. He'll go back the other way. Jacobian back in the midfield. Able to switch it onto the left side, but it's out of play over the far side touch. Behind Dirasuba. So a throw in here for the Galaxy.
A little bit of a different look for FC Shirak, where they've actually pushed Dirasuba out to that left side. You have Kouakou coming to the right side.
A lot of room right now in the middle for the Galaxy. Gerard. Trying to find Robbie Rogers. Let's check that. Robbie Keane cleared away. Now Rogers. Here's Giovanni. Switching onto the left side. Boateng. Overlapping is Romney. Boateng this time top of the area. Not a good pass that time and cleared away. Kouakou. Galaxy do have numbers back. Gerard coming back to help out, and this is going to be a throw-in.
Well, that's interesting on the referee, because that was a foul.
Right.
I mean, Gerard just ran up the player's back, and the referee let that one play on.
He looked over, the referee just looked over to the linesman, or the AR, to be politically correct. And they got the throw out of it, and that's about it. Job by AJ sliding out, able to clear this. Gordo. Here's Gerard. Husicic once again. Keane. Dos Santos. Rogers is on his right side. Back out. Again, Gerard. Left side, Boateng. Romney. Do you want to see a little bit more aggressive from Romney going forward, maybe taking that lane towards goal? Or just be safe?
I think Romney, in his position right now, just needs to play a little bit safe. He's coming a little bit late into the game. And you can't do as much on this left side because Boateng likes to play wide, so he kind of just sits into that space.
Here's Boateng now. He'll get the cross away. And he'll find the far side of the area.
I think we're talking about this as preseason, and it's also about relationships. And Romney and Boateng, if they're going to be playing together on that left side at some point, there needs to be an understanding for Romney when to go forward, but also that communication with Boateng that he needs to pinch inside at times to bring in that defender, open up that space so Romney can come in late and let the ball be played into space and he can run onto it.
Here's FC Shirak now on the counter. Rogers defending on the far side. The ball into the area will come through and Romney able to clear for a throw. Darbignan. Kouakou taken off the ball by Gerard, but this will be another throw in for FC Shirak. 32 minutes into this one. Darbignan. Cross into the area, cleared away by Rogers. Kept alive though on the far side. Davoyan. Lagarza with the clearance. Now here's the part you're talking about earlier, Kobe, right? Keep your head about you. You can tell these guys are tired now.
Yeah, this is your 30 minutes into the match. You're a little bit exhausted. You got the heavy legs. You're coming to the point where Bruce Arena said last week is where they were maxed out at. Now it's about seeing who can push beyond that, who's got the fitness, but most importantly, who can keep their head. As I tell you, when your legs are heavy and you're exhausted, it's hard to keep your concentration going. And it's hard to play simple because you always think that you could just do a little bit more.
Bernardo. You'll find Gordon. Now Romney. Boateng here. Vucic has a little room. Gordon on his left foot this time. Plays it back wide. Again, Boateng. He'll whip it into the area. This time it gets through the six. That was dangerous. Dos Santos keeps it alive along the end line. Still keeping it alive. Puts it back out. Plays it through. Cleared out. Girard this time. Gordo scores. No, he does not. It'll go wide.
Well, there's a little bit of dancing all the way around for the LA Galaxy, but I mean, looking good offensively in those moments where you see Dos Santos dancing on the sideline. But this is a brilliant ball in by Girard. And look at Alan Gordon once again trying to be that last minute man, but just off of the near post for him. But what a brilliant positioning by Girard. And we all know the service that he can put inside the box. But Alan Gordon gets his head on it, but just can't beat the keeper to the near post.
0-0 here, 34th minute. Hey, your five-time MLS Cup champions, the LA Galaxy, continue their quest to be crowned the best club in the region when they take on Santos Laguna in the quarterfinals of the CONCACAF Champions League. It's February 24th right here at StubHub Center. Tickets are on sale now at LAGalaxy.com. We hope to see you here. And that's part of the rebuild of this team is to have the type of talent that can handle such a big tournament, right?
Yeah, that's the important part. I think that's not only for the LA Galaxy, but I think MLS is starting to try to retool a little bit to say, hey, we keep talking about that we want to be one of the best leagues, but we need to start competing at that international level. And CONCACAF Champions League being that big tournament within the region, well, an MLS team needs to step up and win it.
Sidic here for the Galaxy. Girard.
And this referee's letting a lot go.
I think he forgot his whistle. He's in the locker room somewhere. Here's Rogers, and it goes out of play. Throw it. Hey, Galaxy multi-game plans are available for as low as $17.50 per match and allow you access to great savings and preferred seating. Get your plan today at LAGalaxy.com. Play continues with FC Shirak coming out with possession. Galaxy do have some numbers back here. Baggio to Husidic defending, and it will be a goal kick. Good work there by Baggio.
Yeah, excellent defending by Baggio Husidic, making sure that he got back as Robbie Rogers got caught up the field a little bit, but just supporting defensively, getting out there and sticking the toe in. Hoping just to get the tap the ball away, but got a little bit of a lucky bounce off of his opponent to get the goal kick.
Yeah, it worked out. De La Garza. His ball knocked away. Keen to keep it alive here. He's got Boateng on his left. Boateng's cross. This will be punched away by the keeper. Kouakou now plays in towards center as the Galaxy again getting numbers back. This one will come down to Hakobian. He was able to play it on the right side now. Getting numbers forward here. Arbignan plays it through and cleared away by A.J. De La Garza. Corner kick from the right side. That was dangerous.
Yeah, I think you could say that was a little bit dangerous.
A little bit on the dangerous side.
You see the FC Shirak team actually showing their abilities on the counter to get the ball forward. And as you said, change the point of attack quickly and to get the dangerous ball in the box.
Yurasuba plays it through and Leonardo able to clear it out. Here's a throw in on the near side now. 38 minutes in, 0-0. Darmignan. Should be a throw Galaxy, it is. Girard. De La Garza all the way back to Dan Kennedy. Kennedy was the starter in Dallas last year. Until later on in the season, Dallas went really young with Gonzalez in goal. Made available here in the offseason. Bruce Arena said, okay, let's bring him home, bring him back to LA.
I think that was another player that didn't mind coming back to Los Angeles.
No, I think so. I agree with you. Lucidic. Here comes Gordo. He's got Romney. Romney, top of the box, back to Gordon on his right foot. It'll come back out. Can he keep it alive? He does. Dos Santos does. Working on that defender and cleared away. Unfortunately for Allen, that first ball that came in off his right foot might have been the one to take the shot, a one-timer. Kaba able to push the ball left side. Here comes FC Shirak now. 40th minute. Ball into the area for Yurasuba. And a pull down by Kennedy.
A good job by Kennedy for so far for me in this match is that every ball that's come in, even those awkward ones that seem to be, you know, that they'd be dangerous bouncing right before the keeper, he's done an excellent job of getting out and attacking the ball and covering up everything very quickly, not giving away any type of rebound.
Here's Romney. Boateng loses his footing on the surface here. He's going to come back the other way. Yurasuba. Kouakou back to Yurasuba. Ran right into Leonardo and goes down. Ball cleared away, and the Galaxy get a throw out of this. No foul that time?
And actually this one, no foul. This is Yurasuba actually running into the wall of Leonardo. Leonardo just stood his ground, and Yurasuba just actually runs into him. Good no call by the referee on that one.
Okay. Vucinic. Galaxy will work it on the right side. Girard. Now Baggio. Romney. Sidic will have to backtrack.
The Galaxy need to do a better job of getting Baggio, Sidic, or Girard picking up the ball a little bit higher up the field because they're picking it up so deep. When they do change the point of attack to Romney or Rogers, they're receiving the ball in front of the midfielder. They need to pick up that ball behind the midfielder, which will make them much more dangerous.
This looks good for the Galaxy. Keane is onside, off the post. Two good chances here for the Galaxy. Both have found the post.
What we're seeing as far as the sharpness with Robbie Keane, maybe just a little bit off, but here's a great look at it. Usually this is where you expect Robbie Keane to be doing his flipping dance. He puts this one by the keeper. He has the keeper beat, just goes off of the outside of the post. Not quite sure if he was onside on that one. It looked like he might have been a step offside, but still, like we said, this is preseason. This is just figuring out the sharpness. And we can see right now that Robbie Keane's not quite there.
Good chance here for FC Shirak as the ball comes into the area. And out of play on the attempted cross. Malakian that time. Quickly out to Dos Santos now. 43rd minute, Gerard. Alan Gordon checking back. Lots of space now on the pitch. Gerard once again in trouble this time. He's dispossessed the possession. Kouakou. Malakian, it'll come out near side. Habokyan. One more time, Habokyan. Alex, you do well to get numbers back and behind the ball. Romney, though, with a mistake. Darvignan, its opportunity on goal is way wide. In fact, it's going to go out of play, out of touch, that is, for a throw-in.
Well, every announcer always likes this one, right? He takes a shot, and it's out for a throw-in.
Yes.
You know? not the best situation for Darvignan as he's streaking forward. The ball is actually a little bit of a difficult bounce, but he's got to get that on target. He's got to make the keeper at least make a save.
Absolutely. Has to get that one on the frame, as they say. Another chance here, though, for FC Shirak. Things opening up in the middle of the park here. They'll get numbers forward. 44th minute. Dirasuba. Wheeling around to the right side this time. Darvignan once again. He'll go wide, near side. Hakobian. Knocked away by Rogers. This will be a throw.
Well, I think Bruce Arena is going to be somewhat happy with this half. I mean, he's seen some flashes of brilliance from his side. They've made the 45 minutes. Probably not as fit as he'd like to have seen the 45 minutes, but still, this is preseason.
Robbie Keane, Emmanuel Boateng here. Gerard, and cleared out. Hovhannisyan.
Hovhannisyan has done that a couple of times now where he's read the quick touch pass that Gerard wants to do, and he's stepped up and just picked the ball off. Pretty steady defender in the back for FC Shirak.
They've done a very good job of what you talked about earlier when that ball comes across the arc, stepping up, the center back stepping up. They did a pretty good job defensively on that side.
Yeah, defensively, I think they've been very well organized as a side, FC Shirak, and for the Galaxy. Yeah, this is what you want for the first 45 minutes. I think those players have to be happy with what they've done because, as you said, we're going to say it consistently. It's preseason. They're getting their legs underneath them, and you have to be satisfied where you see those moments of sharpness from players that are finally having their first full preseason with the Galaxy when we talk about Gerard and we talk about Dos Santos. And Manuel Boateng looked pretty good, too, on the left.
Thought he had a very good 45. This 11 will go to the locker room and sit the bench in the second half, unless Bruce Arena wants to see a little more from some of them. But we're expecting to see a full new 11 in the second half. Galaxy 0, FC Shirak 0 at the break. Please stay with us.
is hit. And now let's send it down to German, who's on the pitch with some of Andy's biggest fans.
I'm over here with Andy's biggest fan. What's your name?
Eric.
Eric, let me ask you a question. How many times have you seen Andy perform?
Oh, man, I can't even count. It's been so many times over the years.
What's your favorite Andy song?
Probably his edition of Hotel California. It's amazing.
Okay, well, you know what? The Galaxy fans are in for a treat. He's performing at halftime right in midfield. Let's give it up for Andy.
Ladies and gentlemen, internationally famous singer-songwriter Andy has performed sold-out concerts and sold millions of albums worldwide. But one of his most impactful accomplishments has been teaming up with American rockers Bon Jovi. So turn your attention to Galaxy TV for a behind-the-scenes look at this incredible collaboration. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to midfield Iranian, Armenian, American, international recording artist, Andy!
Los Angeles! Thank you. soon.
Closer, I'm coming, and I'm not, she's a new door. hear it for Andy.
Yeah.
right, Galaxy fans, the second half is about to start. It's time to live loud, get loud, let's hear you.
We welcome you back to StubHub Center. The second half about to get underway. Galaxy and FC Shirak scoreless through 45 minutes. A brand new starting 11 here for the second half for the Galaxy. Starts off with Brian Rowe in goal. Turnley on the left side defensively. Steris, Gargan, Sorto is the back line. In midfield, Maganto, Mendiola, Rafa Garcia, Bradford Jameson the fourth. The forwards are Mike McGee and Jose Villarreal. And McGee wearing the captain's armband. Here's Mendiola playing through for Villarreal and cleared away. Here's Bradford Jameson now. So much promise early last season. Injuries cut his season short, unfortunately. Had a great goal at New York, his first career MLS goal at New York Red Bulls. And of course, Mike getting a nice welcome back by the StubHub fans. Be a throw in here for FC Shirak.
Well, this is an interesting lineup that the LA Galaxy have in. A little bit of a on the younger side, a lot of young players. Even though I still think of Mike McGee as a young player, even though he's been in the league for like 20 years.
Yeah, not so young anymore. It is good to see him back, though. And I had a chance to talk to him on Wednesday at the training session, and he's excited to be back here with the LA Galaxy. And excited to have the injuries behind him. It's been a long road back for him. Dan Gargan with the slide tackle there. Dawoyan with this throw-in. Fair to say the first half a good exercise for the Galaxy starters?
Yeah, I think it was a good exercise for the first game for them of the season to have a full match, 11v11, in front of a crowd. I think it was good. 45 minutes, I thought it was pretty solid for them.
Couple of chances. Robbie Keane's hit the post. Alan Gordon's header also kind of glanced the post.
Yeah, those are quality chances. Yeah. That's quality. That's what you want to see early on, because you're only expecting to get better, you know, as this preseason goes over the next, especially the next couple weeks, probably into the, from this point, 2 weeks from now, they'll be vastly different, much better shape.
Nice through ball here from McGee. He's offside, though.
And there he is once again, Mike McGee, always skirting that offside line.
McGee, of course, having a discussion with the near side assistant, pointing to the left back, saying, no, no, he was keeping me onside. I think they got it right this time.
Yeah, McGee was never one to be shy about having a word with the referee.
It's part of his game.
It's part of his personality.
Yeah, I agree with that. Here's Mike on possession now for the Galaxy. Be cleared back, defensively collected. Havonisian. Nice job by Sorto getting it back. He'll have another possession on the right side. Oscar Sorto. It's there by Villarreal. Dan Gargan. Daniel Steris, who in the offseason got an MLS contract with a big club. You may see him in some MLS matches this year, I think. Girasuba. Nice job. Garcia getting back. Maganto. Mike McGee brought down. That's a foul. Free kick. Ovanesian called for the foul there. Raul Mendiola, another player on the edge of getting into the big club as well last season, I thought. Maganto getting pushed off the ball, keeps it in play, does a nice job there. Is it still in? It is. Sorto's cross, a bit short of McGee and cleared away.
Hovhannisian in the right spot once again. He's picking off a lot of balls. You talk about that back line of FC Shirak, you'd have to say that he's the leader. He's the one that stepped up, had the tackle on Mike McGee. He's the one that's cutting off a lot of the balls, a lot of the crosses. Not afraid to get into a tackle.
He's done a very good job. His positioning, as you mentioned, Kobe, has been great throughout the evening. Tough to beat when you're in the right spot all the time. Bradford Jamieson. It's be cleared away. Foul against Sorto. I believe that's 100% more of the whistles than we heard in the first half right there, the second one.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised that the referee is actually blowing the whistle. I didn't know he had one.
Free kick here. Ovanesian. Girasuba. Again, Ovanesian, they work into the middle of the park. Kaba. Good pressure here by the youngsters for the Galaxy. It's done another foul, though. Bradford Jamieson, the fourth. Quickly the restart. Girasuba. They'll work left side this time. Abokyan. One-time cross, it'll be blocked. Here's Maganto. Garcia held up, and that's a foul and a free kick for the Galaxy. Garcia quickly out the left side. Here's Burnley. Jamieson the fourth.
Well, we see with FC Shirak that they, as far as we can tell, they haven't made any changes to their side in this second half. So they're letting their players, you know, run the gauntlet a little bit of time. So for the LA Galaxy with younger players going up against some veteran, I would say more of a veteran side than what the Galaxy has out there, they have to be aware. They have to be paying attention to make sure that they're in the game mentally. Because physically, yes, they'll be able to keep up. They have their youngsters. They have the energy. But now it's about the mental game, those quick restarts, not just watching the ball all the time, but making sure that you're focused on the match and everything that's going on at every moment.
Here's Mendiola for the Galaxy. Able to find McGee. Back out, Raul. He'll go right side. Maganto. He's got Soto overlapping. He'll find him. Oscar, can he get the cross away? He does. Down low in front, they score! Jose Villarreal! And it is 1-0 in favor of the LA Galaxy here in the 54th minute. Good cross on the part of Soto on the line right in front.
Well, this is a brilliant cross, you know, from Soto. It's just a little bit of a combination play and an overlap that happens on the right flank for the LA Galaxy. And you can see here a little bit slow from Jacobian to get out there, allows the cross to come in, and then Jose Villarreal just sneaks behind the back line of SC Chirac, and a player that we have been talking about, Jovenician, about the proper positioning, well, that time he gets caught. He doesn't know where Villarreal is, and Villarreal just sneaks behind. I think he was expecting his teammate, Jacobian, to step out and actually block that cross, but he gets caught.
And the Galaxy take advantage. Here's another chance as the ball comes ahead, intended for McGee. To be cleared away, though. This time, Baganto clears it out.
Yeah, we'll see how this works for FC Chirac, how they respond. Because the LA Galaxy really on a play where they made something out of nothing. They
absolutely
end up scoring the goal. There were much more dangerous chances in the first half for the LA Galaxy where you expected them to score, and they didn't. So we'll see what happens here, if it inspires this FC Chirac side to be a little bit more aggressive going forward.
Here they come on that right flank. Galaxy want a handball. They're going to get it. Free kick for LA here. Burnley. Rafa Garcia wheels it around, finds Dan Cargan. Tries to knock it forward, this will be cleared out. Cargan to keep it alive, pushed off the ball. That's a foul and a free kick.
Well, that's another player, Dan Cargan, that's being asked to play a little bit of a different position, playing that inside center back on the right-hand side. You know, he's used to playing out on the right flank, getting up and down. Maybe this will give him a little bit more, a little bit more confidence where he doesn't have to put all that effort out on trying to get forward, where he can actually just concentrate on his defensive part of his game.
And be more of a leader down there, more of an organizer, right?
For sure.
Villarreal. Able to go wide on the left. There's the cross. Not a bad cross, by the way. Maganto got on the end of it. It's going to be actually a corner kick here for the Galaxy. So corner coming from the near side. The Galaxy with a set play opportunity. Maybe able to double up their lead here, leading 1-0. Maganto. Not a very large lineup out there for the Galaxy right now, though. Bradford, Jamison, Steris are the biggest players. Here comes the cross into the area. Shot from outside by Garcia is cleared away. Cargan under some pressure here from Diarasuba. Back to the goalkeeper, Rowe. Rowe has not been asked to do much so far here in the first 12 minutes or so.
I think the Galaxy have done a good job of keeping possession in the second half. And they've actually put a lot more pressure in totality than the Galaxy did in the first half, as far as keeping the ball in FC Chirac's defensive half, moving their defense around. You know, a lot of it could be due, you know, this is the second half for this FC Chirac mm-hmm. side. They haven't made any changes, so maybe their legs are starting to get a little bit heavy.
They're going to make one here in the not-too-distant future. They have a player ready to go. Here's Mendiola trying to send Mike McGee through. That pass may be a bit late, but a good job defensively, those as well. It's going to be a foul against the Galaxy. 59th minute now. Malakian play on the right side. Edgar Malakian this time. No foul. We continue. Galaxy come out with possession. Good play by Jameson there, dispossessing the player. Garcia. Now Burnley. Armin Hovhannisyan is the player that will be coming on in a moment. Here comes the substitution. Akobian is out. Thought he had a pretty good first half, Akobian.
Akobian did very well. Maybe he's a little bit at fault, a little bit of laziness on getting out to block that cross, but offensively, he was strong getting forward and just being dangerous inside the box.
Sorto. Nice pass by Sorto, finding Villarreal, nutmegging the defender, comes back out for Oscar. Can he keep it alive? He does, good work. And finds Gargan. Garcia, under some pressure there from Kouakou. Now Sorto, trying to find Baganto. Second ball comes back. Mendiola wants the handball here. He's going to get it, free kick. Malakian was the player called. So we actually have four players with the same name on the field. Well, two and two, let's put it that way. So when you hear it, you're going to hear a lot of Hovhannisyan and Malakian here for FC Shirak. A pair are brothers, the other ones aren't related. And I don't have enough information to tell you which is which, so. The two most storied clubs in MLS history, your five-time MLS Cup champions, open the season against DC United Sunday, March 6th, in a match presented by StubHub. Tickets start as low as $20 per match at LAGalaxy.com. $20 for this match at LAGalaxy.com. Sunday evening, I believe, is that time. 6 o'clock. 1-0 Galaxy here, 61st minute with Kobe Jones, Joe Tutino. Thank you for joining us here at LAGalaxy.com. Nice to get the season back underway. Good ball up the left side here. Sorto defending against Malakian. The cross into the area and pulled down by Brian Rowe.
Here's a look at this ball. Just a little bit of a deflection. It goes off and, you know, maybe one of the... No, I still wouldn't say that Brian Rowe's been tested so far in this second half.
That's routine for him, no? Another handball here.
Yeah, it almost seems like the FC Shirak players are just a little bit exhausted, a little bit heavy-legged. But, you know, from their schedule right now, I mean, it's not the easiest thing to be traveling to the United States on a plane for a few hours.
Yes.
They were also just in Russia as well, so they've been all over the world right now. And I can tell you from personal experience, flying across the globe is not the easiest thing to do.
Yes.
And then to play a match right after it.
And you've done some pretty good, some globe trotting yourself, Kobe, and to play an exhibition match and to spend time and to do some community relations, right, while you're there as well.
Yeah, you get asked to do a lot, and just like these FC Shirak players, once they've been here, you know, I'm sure besides the training and all the travel, they have to put in a little time. You know, they've been out in the Glendale area, you know, where there's a large Armenian community, and just, you know, like you said, giving back and, you know, going out and seeing their fans.
Yeah.
It's a good thing to do.
Here's Sorto. He'll run it back into his own defense. Gargan. Again, Sorto under some pressure. He'll get the throw. He was hoping for that ball to go to the far side. And release the pressure that was on, but the Galaxy now working on the near side again. Obanisian will get this one back in front of Villarreal. It comes out to Caba. His pass is broken up. Kouakou, and cleared off of his foot. No foul. We continue. Obanisian. Malakian. Kouakou able to get on the end of this one. Davoyan. Dirasuba. Now the shot towards goal over the bar and out of play. That was a very nice buildup. Obanisian with the shot.
That's probably the best buildup we've seen from FC Shirak in this second half. Just a nice quick combination play and getting that ball to the feet of Obanisian. And Obanisian is doing a good job of just tucking in from that right-hand side. As you can see, he just sneaks in, gets the ball off of his foot quick. You know, as he gets underneath it, you can tell even as the foot comes off the ball, he's already got his head down knowing that that's not going to be on target.
Here's Caba now. Jamison trying to get back. He finds Obanisian, able to keep possession. Dirasuba tries to wheel it around left side. It's going to be a foul against the Galaxy's Jamison. And a free kick here. Coming into this year, some of these players, these young stalwarts, from a coaching standpoint, do you have an expectation of them? Do you want to see them get to a certain level? For example, Jamison the fourth, Mendiola, Sorto. We've talked about Sorto potentially being an MLS player for the last couple of years.
Well, you want to see them continuously to improve. You know, that's what it's all about. And to be blunt, at some point, they have to stand out
right.
And be a star at this level of the game to make it to the first team. If you don't, you could find yourself stagnating consistently at this level. So you have to find a way to break out and be seen and be noticed at some point.
Another one of those players is getting close to that you want to see stardom from on a consistent basis, Ari Lassiter. Here comes FC Shirak. Good work there by Jamison the fourth, and the shot from distance is wide.
Yeah, the big issue is that shot goes wide. The big issue is for these players to realize that you're at the LA Galaxy. It's going to be difficult to break in, especially nowadays as we're seeing like the bigger clubs within MLS are very willing to go outside and buy players and bring them in when necessary.
Heavy touch there by Rowe, but able to clear it. Play starting to open up and getting a bit physical now. Jamison with possession, finds Garcia. He'll knock it back for Sorto. Mike McGee.
Mike McGee, always a calming factor on the ball.
It's a dangerous play here coming through. Kouakou wiping out Steris, I believe. Or was that Dan Gargan? Gargan got wiped out there. And a yellow card. Hey, the best seats in the house, the best price. 2016 season tickets are on sale now for as low as $19.50 per match. Become a part of the family today at LAGalaxy.com. Still 1-0 Galaxy here. The goal by Villarreal. Garcia.
Yeah, it's interesting to think as well when we talk about this FC Shirak side and how they are in the middle of the season. You also have to remember as well this is their midseason break where they're starting to prepare and get ready for their season, which will start in early March as well, like the Galaxy. So they've got a few players that, you know, probably taking a little bit of time off, and you know, they're working their way back into fitness too.
Which is a bit surprising that they haven't made wholesale changes. Only one change so far.
Different coaches, different philosophies,
yeah.
Right? I wouldn't be surprised if maybe this FC Shirak side is probably a little bit farther along in their preseason than the LA Galaxy is.
Girasuba. Obanisian keeps it in play. Nice job by Maganto winning this one back. Mendiola knocking it forward. Stamenkovic this time. Down the middle of the park. Out comes Rowe, able to clear that away. Good job by Brian.
Well done by Rowe, just making sure that he was attentive to what was going on and just sneaking off of his line quickly.
Villarreal. It's Mendiola. Stara is able to go left side, Burnley. Here was an opportunity, though, for FC Shirak. Kouakou taking off the ball there. Obanisian. Good move here as they take it on the right side. This could be a penalty. No, says the referee. The shot towards goal. It'll go wide of the far post and out of play. Goal kick. Dangerous that time.
Extremely dangerous by the LA Galaxy. I mean, you know, it's always questionable when there's a foul inside the box and both sides stop thinking that there's going to be a whistle. And now we'll have a look at it here. There's a bit of a dribble in. Now, it's difficult to tell because there's a player in, but I believe it's Gargan that might have made a little bit of contact. It's hard to see, but, you know, when both sides kind of stop and look, everyone's kind of expecting the referee to blow the whistle, but nothing comes. You got to play on.
And we do here. Although on that replay, it did look like there was some contact. Sorto now. Finds McGee. Mendiola. Ran into the defender. Maganto keeps it alive for the Galaxy. Back to Steris. Here's Maganto. Sprays this to the right side. Mendiola brings it down well onto his left foot. A little too much on that ball because it was going right to his favorite left foot. And the defender did a great job of clearing it out. This will be a possession to the Galaxy, but first the substitution for FC Shirak.
Yeah, but a great touch by Mendiola to take that first touch across the defender's face so he can't be fouled.
Hey, your five-time MLS Cup champion LA Galaxy continue their quest to be crowned the best club in the region when they take on Santos Laguna in the quarterfinals of CONCACAF Champions League play February 24th right here at StubHub Center. Tickets are on sale right now at LAGalaxy.com. Cuadio coming onto the field as the cross is taken on the corner kick. Cleared away for a moment. Gor Malakian able to clear it out. This will be a throw-in. Obanisian. Malakian. Kouakou working on Steris this time. Goal kick.
Well, that was a little bit hopeful by Kouakou. Not exactly sure what he was trying to do there because Steris had him. He had him positioned the right way where he wasn't going to be able to get a good shot off. Just had him angled facing away from goal, but I think Kouakou thought he could basically try to pull something off. Brilliant. That was a pretty hopeful shot.
Yeah, that or the fact that maybe he didn't know where he was exactly in the box.
Well, I'm hoping that a striker at a on a professional team knows where he is in the box when he's shooting. So I'm hoping that he was thinking he was going to do something brilliant.
We'll give him the benefit of the doubt. We're going to get a substitution here for FC Shirak. A couple of players, it looks like. No, one. Ivar Zavuziwan Ivyzon coming on. And Edgar Malakian is done. Hovhannisyan on the throw-in. He'll get it back. Here's Malakian. Heels wide. Diarra Suba cleared away. Another ball into the area this time. Brian Rowe able to pull it down. Steris, 75th minute, pickpocketed here. It's a good chance on goal. The shot, and they score. They've tied it up. Ivyzon with the game-tying goal. We're tied at 1-1.
Well, Ivyzon coming on as the super sub comes in for less than a minute, and he gets the goal to tie up the match. Bit of a mistake for the LA Galaxy out of the back, getting pressured early on, and then just a good heads-up play, playing the ball right across the top of the box. Ivyzon just sitting there at the penalty spot. Not much you can do if you're the defenders at that point to try to close it down, because he's wide open. Everyone's already moved up the field expecting the ball to go forward. And now the game, the match is tied 1-1, and this is a good test now for these young players to see how they can respond after taking a goal.
Mike BD is done for the night. Half hour's work for him. Here comes Ari Lassiter. Galaxy 1, FC Shirak 1. This side right now looks very much like Galaxy 2. The ball comes through intended for Lassiter. Yes, the son of Roy Lassiter, that's him. Lots of qualities there from Ari Lassiter that we have been able to see with Galaxy 2 last year. Hey, you know, your five-time MLS Cup champion LA Galaxy continue their preseason action. Be there when Robbie Keane, Steven Gerrard, Giovanni Dos Santos, and your LA Galaxy welcome back Juninho and Club Tijuana Tuesday, February 9th. Tickets on sale now at LAGalaxy.com. Hovhannisyan. Nice job that time by Gargan, winning it back. Sorto back to his keeper. All right, Kobe, you talked earlier about the young guys keeping their head in the game. They're looking a little ragged right now.
Well, that's to be expected as they take a goal.
Right.
And one of the calming factors has also been substituted off with Mike McGee being that player that's always calm on the ball offensively. Now it's about who can step up as a young player and be that calming influence. I mean, you have Dan Gargan back there, but he's in the defensive position, so he can't really affect the strikers and the offensive midfielders to hold on to the ball.
Kouakou back out wide. Diarra Suba and cleared away by Sorto back in the midfield. Villarreal gets the foul here. Free kick for the Galaxy. Rafa Garcia to take it. 79 minutes in, we're 1-1 now. Throwing again.
Yeah, not the best free kick to be taken. Yes, in the long run, you've gained some ground there. A little bit lucky. They've got to keep the ball on the ground, keep possession. They've been doing well when they've done that.
Here's Maganto. Two defenders on him. He wants the foul. He's going to get it. He earned it. Free kick. This ball will be just inside the corner kick spot. Jose Villarreal is there. Jameson goes to the back post. Villarreal plays it low this time, off the chest and cleared away. Gargan. Burnley down low in front to Steris, played it back across and cleared away.
Now that's what happens when you have a defender on the ball inside the 18. He actually had time where he could actually maybe have a touch to one side or the other and then get a shot off.
Here's another ball in for Maganto, plays it back out towards the spot. Here's Villarreal for his second. And it's 2-1 Galaxy, Jose Villarreal, two goals on the night.
Well, I tell you, that's an absolutely brilliant run from Mendiola down that left-hand side. Elects not to take the shot, which I'm surprised. He could have taken that shot, but puts that ball across the box once again. And Villarreal, one thing we know that he is good at, and that's shooting.
Yes.
Anything inside the 18, he is sound, so sound with that. A great connection on the ball. Just that little bit of a jump so he can get over the ball and have good connection. Nice to put the ball in the back of the net. Two goals for Villarreal, not bad so far.
And you're so right, it was Raul Mendiola that made that late run.
Thank you.
Nice ball back into the area. Not a bad night for Jose so far. Kouakou now for FC Shirak. It'll go right side. Garcia this time, Mendiola. Back out Gargan, 81st minute here. Lassiter lets it go past the defender, Hovhannissian, and here comes Ari Lassiter, puts on the brakes, on his left foot, near post, and it's just wide.
Well, that's a little look at the abilities of Ariel Lassiter. Reminiscent of his father.
Yes.
He's got the speed, the pace, and this is a great little touch just to have the defender sliding by. You know, could have gone either way. Maybe he takes that another touch forward and makes it a little bit easier for himself, because here with that cutback, it actually allows the defender to step in front of a clean shot of what he could have had before.
Kids putting on a show, though, some of them out there.
Yeah, but what's needed. This is what they have to understand. You're in the professional ranks now. If you want to be a professional player, this is where you have to shine to show that, okay, I'm one of the best here, so I'm ready to move up to the next level.
Another ball down the middle intended for Maganto. Good job defensively that time. It's going to be a throw.
And also for these young men, I mean, it's about, you know, maybe their future, and this isn't a negative, maybe the future isn't with the Galaxy.
Right.
You know, but if you have a good showing here, others could be looking at this and say, hey, we want this person on our team.
Here's Jameis in the fourth, and he goes near post. This ball was deflected, I believe, and out. Corner kick. Keep on building your value. Your value could be to your team, but somebody else might say, hey, you can help me out.
Yeah, sometimes, you know, as a player, you have to look at the selfish side of it, too. You know, you want to help out your team with the Galaxy in the future and go to
sure.
the full team. But if it's not meant to be and somebody else comes in, I'm pretty sure the Galaxy are willing to sell people. We've seen it already.
Here's the corner. It'll come through. And goal kick here. 84 minutes in with the Galaxy on top, 2-1 so far. Jose Villarreal will be the hero. He's got two goals on the night for the LA Galaxy, both in the second half. Both well taken. Free kick. Fans, your five-time MLS Cup champion, LA Galaxy, continue their preseason action, I should say, their quest for club supremacy in the region when they take on Santos Laguna in the quarterfinals of CONCACAF Champions League, February 24th, right here at StubHub Center. Tickets on sale right now at LAGalaxy.com. Here's Caba. Kind of quiet in the second half, right? Caba?
Yeah, I don't think Caba has been moving as well as he had in the first half. It might be the legs.
Here's a go at goal, and wide of the far post. Dangerous shot from distance there. Coadio.
Yeah, we see Coadio. Yeah, as he steps up, a little bit of an awkward stride from Coadio. It goes wide, but I think Rowe had it covered. But, you know, not as fluid in the second half for FC Shirak. It seems like every once in a while they're getting opportunities at goal. Just the rhythm, I think, with their substitutions has thrown them off in the second half.
Villarreal, he'll get the foul here. Free kick. I think the fans that have come out here to support the Galaxy have enjoyed tonight's match, as well as the fans that here locally for FC Shirak have enjoyed the evening. Rowe. You'll find Villarreal here. Burnley.
See, that's a little bit different from what we saw in the first half, is Villarreal just dropping into the midfield and being able to pick up the ball freely with no type of pressure around him whatsoever.
Gargan. Mendiola, who has an assist on the night. Lassiter. Here's Maganto. Again, Mendiola just offside. Maybe the pass came a bit late. But possession back to FC Shirak. Club Tijuana coming here on February the 9th. Later on, Seattle Sounders will be here. Season gets underway on the 6th. Won't want to miss this one. 2016 could be special.
Now, I think the Galaxy, they're making sure that they have quite a few matches, like full matches, before they step up and have to play in the CONCACAF Champions League. I think this year they're looking to have a good showing, making that run to be that first MLS team that wins it all.
A couple of times, last time they were in it, I think there was that desire, that thought that there was a team that could get it done. And it's such a tough time for MLS clubs at this time of year, at this part of the year, to be at a level necessary.
Well, that's the big part, is the way this CONCACAF Champions League works, is that it falls into the preseason of MLS squads. You know, when you're talking about these rounds, we're talking about these quarterfinal rounds. When it comes down to it, this is it's basically MLS versus Liga MX.
Right.
What it comes down to, I mean, the matchups are pretty incredible.
Here's Jameson. Lost his footing there for a moment, regrouped. Battle, but unfortunately it'll go back the other way. This ball is in play still. Kouakou, nice move that time. Stara is able to clean it up. And we continue. I believe our referee is saying there'll be 2 minutes of added time. And we have a player down, so that could be extended a little bit more. A little hamstring, it looks like. Maybe a cramp. So we'll have 2 minutes of added time. Now, Juninho's had a pretty good start with Tijuana. He's got a goal and an assist to my count that I know about. He just scored in their last match. And knowing the player the way we've had a chance to know him, it's probably going to be an emotional game for him coming back here. Steris. Finding Jameson, able to clear it up into the offensive end. Albanese in the keeper. This will be a foul, free kick. Another substitution here for FC Shirak. Rafa Garcia not happy. With Kaba there. Took a pretty good knock.
Substitution for FC Shirak in the 90th minute. Taking the game, number 9,
So Kouakou is done. Mouradian will replace him. Closing moments of this one now. See if the Galaxy can hold on and get the 2-1 win. Gargan will take the restart. Albanese unable to clear. Steris knocks it back in. Ari Lasser in an offside position there. Albanesian. He's going to knock this one forward. Headed away by Sordo. Villarreal. Lassiter if he wants him. Villarreal will knock it near side to keep possession. Jameson the help out. Goes in hard. Play will continue here. Girasuba, he's brought down. That'll be a foul and a card to Maganto. That is called the tactical foul right there, no?
I think that's what they call it. They don't call it the professional foul anymore.
But I like calling it the professional foul, but yeah. It is what it is.
Yeah, tactical foul because it really did look like a Girasuba could have been going through towards goal with players streaking in. So, yeah, a good foul at this point, but now it's just about for these young players. These are the moments. You know, it's the last minutes of the game. They're going to put everybody forward. They're going to put the numbers up. Can you be calm here and make the play? That's what it's about right now, making the play.
Darbignan will take this restart. Goes top of the penalty area. Knocked away, kept alive for a moment. Again, Darbignan. Another ball top of the box, cleared out by Garcia. Our referee looking at his watch. And that is it. 90 minutes of soccer here at StubHub Center. The LA Galaxy behind two goals from Jose Villarreal win 2-1 over FC Shirak. Not a bad start to the exhibition season. I think the coaching staff got good information from this.
Yeah, I think it was good for the coaching staff to see all the players from the first and the second half. Very good combination play from some of the DP players in the first half for the Galaxy, but also I think we saw some players step up in this second half, some of the younger players showing that they're ready to give and help out the Galaxy first team. You know, when we talk about Villarreal and what he did there, we talk about, I like Maganto on that right-hand side, did some good work as well.
Mendiola got the assist. You mentioned him and his hard work keeping that ball in play. Maybe could have taken a shot, but decided to knock it back across.
Well, it's good vision for a young player like that to be able to see that, because, you know, personally, if I'm out there, I'm taking the shot. I'm going for the glory for myself, but for him to notice that Villarreal was open on that back post and to put that across, well done for Mendiola.
Well, the Galaxy get the 2-1 win on a nice night here at StubHub Center. It is back. It is nice to have the MLS season just beyond our reach right now, but it's nice to be back here at StubHub Center. We thank you for joining us here at LAGalaxy.com. For Kobe Jones, Joe Tutino, saying so long. We'll talk to you again on the 9th when the Galaxy take on Club Tijuana right here at StubHub Center. Tickets available at LAGalaxy.com. Once again, the final score, LA Galaxy 2, FC Shirak 1. Have a great night.